when you talk about restoring something, it's about making a connection to the past, to history. I'm going to try to make that connection here to show what honor, courage, and love is all about, and make a connection to the past, another piece of history that you don't know, have never seen, a name that you probably have never heard. You know what these are? These are the shoes of a woman named Ryo Sato. Japanese shoes. These were her little sandals. Little Japanese woman, except she's not Japanese, she's of Japanese descent. She was born here in the United States in 1913, if my memory serves me correctly. She was an artist. She was a good artist, too. This is a picture that she painted. It's a picture of what life was like in 1940. In California. She lived in California. She was born in California. And she went to work for the WPA, which is the arts program for the United States. It was a Roosevelt thing. It was basically propaganda, American propaganda. So here she is, this Japanese, as the war is starting to heat up, she decides that she's going to do American propaganda. Her heart is in the right place. She wants to help and serve her country. Well, when she joins the WPA, she then, unfortunately, falls under this. Because when she joins the WPA, she is living in the Presidio in San Francisco, California. She's living in that area. This is civilian exclusion over Order 41. I've had this now for about a year. This was actually hanging at the Presidio. In 1942. Presidio of San Francisco, California, May 5th, 1942, Civilian Exclusion Order Number 41. And basically what it says is, hey, you know what? Are you Japanese descent? Have we got a deal for you? You're going on a vacation. Except it's not really a vacation. Born in 1913 in the United States, she packs up her stuff with her family. She leaves. This is actually in an art museum when she goes and sees this exclusion order, and she takes the family and she goes to her first internment camp. This is her art of the first internment camp. This is not a fancy camp. In fact, this is really, really bad. For 3 months, she lived at a racetrack. She and her family were stuffed into a horse stall. She late in life talked to her family about how bad it was and how smelly it was and how they were cramped, and they lived in an old horse stall for 3 months until the train came to town. Come on, everybody, get your tickets on the party train. It's the soul train, where everybody driving the train is going to lose their soul. She gets onto the train, and it takes her to Heart Mountain. It's in Wyoming, where it is 30 below zero. So she's gone from this to this. This is a sketch of Gates of Heart Mountain. And it's an internment camp. Make no mistake, it's an internment camp. It's a concentration camp. So what does she do? Here's a woman who has her art in an art gallery. She's been serving her country. She was born in America. Sure, she's got funny shoes. She was born in America. What does she do? She decides to write everybody that she can, the YMCA and everybody else, and she gets paper, and as much paper as she can, and rice paper. And she decides that she is going to teach the kids in the internment camp art. And this is the art that she does. Can you pull into this? There it is. She pulls this out and she does this art. Notice It's a Japanese girl and an American, a white girl, holding hands. Now, can I ask you something? Do you do this? Do you do this? That is remarkable. She leaves the internment camp after the war is over, and she serves, and then she starts to travel the world, and she goes into advertising for a while, and she travels in every single, there she is, every single Christmas, her family gets another card from her on one of her many trips. She died, I believe it was last October. I wish I could have met her. I will tell you, I acquired these things 2 weeks ago, and this has sat in my living room. This, everything else goes into a vault, but this is sitting in my living room. And everybody who comes into my house hears this story in the last couple of weeks. I think she's one of the greatest Americans who's ever lived. She conducted herself with honor, her whole life, honor. When her own country, who she was serving, scoops her up and puts her behind barbed wire, still honor. And she begs, she doesn't steal, she begs and she borrows for paper to teach art. And what is that art teaching? Love. Courage. Courage. When she comes back home, she was described as intensely pro-American. She never lost the love for her country, no matter what others did to her. When she was in Heart Mountain, Wyoming, the boards started to separate because they weren't dried. So they started to separate. And in the winter, there were gaps in the boards, 30 below zero, blowing snow and cold into the horse barn was starting to look like a palace. The courage it took for her. And yet, she never turned to hatred. Honor, courage, and love. Get the last piece in 16 days here in Dallas, Texas.